All right, everybody. This is we just got to the shop. It's almost 11 now, and I just had something amazing happen that was funny. And because everybody knows the Daily Dose is my one way to make sure that I have evidence of everything I do over the last few years, good and the bad, once again, I got some more evidence for you. So I'm sitting here, and I get this phone call, and I look at the phone number, and I go, what? That can't be right. And I check, and I look down at my phone again, and then I answer it, and it's Dr. Reefer, the secretary from Dr. Reefer, calling to invite us to a special clinic. So I'm going to go to my phone. You see my little phone right here where it says received? So you don't think I'm cheating. Let's go to received. I'll click on it. What's that number right there? It's 256-0420. Okay? Everybody can see it right there. Well, that's Dr. Reefer's number at 10:51 a.m. Called, told us about this special clinic going on Saturday for all the owners, and we're invited. I said, oh my God, I'm in shock. I can't believe this. Okay, I'm going to do my best to be there, but I don't have any transportation because the DEA's coming and took all my stuff. So I'm going to try to be there. I was shocked. I couldn't believe it. I was ready. I was all excited. I thought that for once, maybe the people had realized that we need to do things not only screaming like the feds did something, but we also need to sit down as a group among the local cannabis businesses and talk amongst each other without fighting about what good business practices and what bad business practices are or may not be, or aren't. But boom, what happened was is a few seconds later, we get a call back. Oh, sorry, James, is this James? No, you guys aren't invited. Well, here's the truth. I would have went to support the patients because special clinics, I'm hoping, support the patients. But to be truthful, that's all I would have been there for. The reason that nobody is calling us and reaching out, other than Michael McAuliffe, who reached out, when you do stuff like that, no wonder. You just scream out loud, hey, we're doing mad shit. That's why we can't even ask these people to team up with us to fight. I mean, it's amazing. I wish you the best of luck on any charges that you may face. I truly do. I'm sad that you faced your prison sentences, Pierre. I truly am. Trust me, nobody should go to prison for a cannabis-related charge. It's that simple. But there are certain things that you should and shouldn't do. And while you might say that being in the Fed toughened you up and made you say, you know what, screw them, I'm just going to make this happen and show them, you'll get a lot farther with honey and knowledge than salt and screaming. Remember that. So we're glad that we were invited and then uninvited. Shows me everything I need to know about that type of organization, and it shows why we continue to do what we do with MCCMB. We have our own plan on what we're going to do. We know what we've been providing to the patients, and we know that after the investigations, when they unlay all the charges and everything, we know where we're going to stand. All right? Now, has MCCNV possibly broken a federal law? We don't know. Have we broken state laws? No, we have not. If we did, then they would have investigated us. They wouldn't keep asking me for the fees for our licenses and all that kind of good stuff. So we just wanted to let you know about the invite, the uninvite, and that hopefully one day people will realize why stuff like this ends up in the paper and why we have people in the cannabis community that shouldn't be speaking on the cannabis community's behalf. So it talks about this story here, and this is today's review journal. This is in the health and medicine section from the front, Thursday, September the 16th, 2010. So everybody go out and get your review journal. But it says right here, legal drug use on the rise in the U.S., survey says, and it talks about, you know, the wrong message being sent on marijuana, health official says. Really? You have been sending the wrong message. You've been lying to generations of people about the greatest plant on earth. Not only does it have medicinal benefits, but one of my new camp, what would Jet do? And that's the, now we're not just going to hit you with the medical benefits. Now we're just going to unleash the complete benefits of the hemp plant. So we're going to come with facts and science like we always do. We're going to continue to fight and defend the patients of Nevada and what we do here as a charity at MCCMB. And we're also going to try to fight against stuff like this. where they put this propaganda based on fear, and then what do they follow it up with? Mom accused of giving marijuana to a 2-year-old. All right. That just shows they should title that Mom is Stupid. That has nothing to do with marijuana. It would have been the same if Mom had given her child bleach, we wouldn't even be seeing this. It would be in the local paper there. But because they wanted to throw the word marijuana in, and now marijuana can sell some papers, great. Great. At least they're not filing lawsuits. So make sure you get your review journal to read the start of the propaganda and smear to go along with the hey, this report shows that drug use is on the rise and that we're giving the wrong ideas about marijuana. I love it. I love it. I love it. It's awesome. Now, also, last minute stuff to talk about. We've been getting some calls from some major media outlets. I'm inexperienced with this. So if there is any talent agencies or lawyers that are agents or whatever, please contact us. I have a burner phone right now, but honestly, if you have any kind of, just come to the office. It's that simple. Or call me directly, 702-286-7052, so we can set up an appointment on where we can meet at. But I'm definitely looking for representation from like an agent or a lawyer of some type for like media things and stuff like that. And we're also looking for an advertising agency or a small film company to produce a 20 to 30 minute film that we know is just going to be absolutely amazing. And also a news organization. Contrary to popular belief, Channel 8 News has never once made a donation to us. We don't pay them for anything. In fact, I could care less about any news organization. But when someone gives us opportunity to speak, we're going to. So here you go, news organizations. If you want a chance to hear MCCNV side of the story and our stance on the raids and how we feel about the cannabis community as a whole, once again, 702-286-7052. Please leave an understandable message. Or jp@mccnv.com or drgreenbeard@mccnv.com. All right, everybody. We hope your Thursday is rocking along. And we will see you later on as the need for more videos arise, because they keep coming right and left. Thanks again, Dr. Reaver, for not inviting us to one of your special clinics, because over the last 2.5 years, I've spent most of my time helping to right the wrongs that some of your probably special clinics have created for patients here in Nevada. Good luck, guys. We wish you the best. All of the patients out there, it's unfortunate that the profit mongers that are trying to do business for profit, you know what? It's unfortunate that the leadership that's going to be out there and available for people to see and that gets thrown out to the front, for the most part here locally, they're going to get thrown to the front. Don't worry. MCCNV is always going to be here educating and informing patients. That's just the way it's going to be. All right, everybody. Enjoy the rest of your Thursday. We'll see you later on.